What's up, YouTube? Today I'm going to show you how to turn a flower pot into a pond. Let's go. First, you're going to need a flower pot with no holes on the bottom.
You're going to need rocks, wood,
gravel, aquatic plants, and some sort of filter.
The first thing you want to do is set your filter in your pot. Once your filter is in place, it's time to add the substrate. My substrate is going to be gravel. Add about a half inch to an inch of gravel to the bottom of your pot. Once your substrate is added to your pond, you can now use bigger rocks to build a base to hide the filter. So this is my first design. I have a cave for the filter so the intake isn't blocked. And then I built rocks up around as you saw and then put a piece of slate over the top. Now that this is finished, we need to add plants. Aquatic plants like this are really helpful in making your patio pond look natural. You can take these plants and stick them in the cracks and crevices of the rocks that will still be in the water. In order to fit the reeds in the right places, you're probably going to have to make some adjustments with your rocks as you go along. There is no one right way to do this. In fact, I had to plan this whole thing out beforehand, and once I had it figured out, I took it down, and for the video, I ended up making something totally different. So as long as the roots are in the water, this reed should do well. Aquatic grasses also look good. Now that all the plants are added, you may choose to add some driftwood. I like how that looks. Now, you want to slowly add your water to your patio bowl pond. Now that your water's added, all that's left to do is make a couple adjustments and plug it in. I'll need a heavy duty weatherproof extension cord because my outlet's too far away. Time to plug it in. So not only is a patio pond something that you guys can do, but you can do it cheaply. This cost me no extra money, and I just used materials that I had laying around the house. This pot is just an old garden pot laying around. I had all these rocks, I found the plants from a pond, I already had the wood, and the filter is an old filter I already had. I mean, even if you had to buy the filter, this thing would only cost you about $20. So guys, if you do this on your own, don't get frustrated when you can't figure out how to put all the rocks together first, because to be honest, it took me a long time and I had to plan this out before I took the video. I had to mess around and figure out where I thought everything was gonna go. So just have patience and I think you guys will be able to do this. Y'all, I gotta add some fish in here soon because this would look epic with some like guppies or some platies or something like that that I can keep for the summer. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. What fish should I get for this patio bowl pond? Guys, that should wrap this up. I'm super stoked with how this turned out, and I'm excited to see how this video will do and what you guys think about it. So make sure you like if you like this video and leave a comment down below, because I don't know what you guys want to see. I've done some videos where I make projects, other videos where I'm just running around and jumping into water. So I want to know what you guys want to see. So let me know in the comments below. With all that being said, thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace out. Who wants to see tubing and air stones in their aqua feature? Boom, look at these plants. I rinsed them out because that might be really gross. Okay guys, now we're gonna go get some hornwort from the pond. And we're gonna get some plants for the patio bowl.
Beautiful.
That's disgusting.